way I would go about to explain it, if I talk to, I don't know, my father-in-law, yeah, then it's more like taking from existing computers. It is a known fact that, you know, computers and information technologies are shrinking down. And so at some point, of course, it's clear we will reach some atomic scale. And then at atomic scale, there are some phenomena which are totally, you know, unprecedented and totally different than what you are used to in a classical world. And for instance, you know, here, superposition of states. And here, of course, I mean, something that is useful for explaining it to people is maybe the Schrödinger cat paradox. You can have something, you know, in different places at the same time. And also entanglement, which is, you know, maybe more subtle to understand. And one thing I use to explain it normally to non-technical people is like teleportation, you know, or quantum communication in general type of things that you can produce. And there people start kind of getting, you know, the understanding that, you know, the microscopic world, the quantum world, is at least working with entirely different laws than we have at microscopic level. And then, of course, I would explain that, you know, these phenomena which are unconceivable in our world, maybe even paradoxical, can be used to build something. For instance, quantum register, because if you can have one atom, one quantum bit, which you can put in a superposition, you have many of them, then you can put, you know, them in a superposition of many possible numbers that are encoded there, okay? And then this brings with itself some concept of, you know, parallel processing, and then, I mean, the idea that there can be some power in quantum algorithms. Beyond what I just said, that is more or less, you know, the typical way one would explain these things. Maybe there is a fundamental question: can we possibly bring these revolutionary concepts to ordinary people the same way that previous revolutions have been brought to ordinary people? If I think of, I don't know, Copernicus revolution, okay, or maybe even relativity theory, those things have had, you know, a translation, maybe even in narrative, okay? You can read stories and you know, authors have written about these things, because you can get a mental representation of these things. But can you get a mental representation of a quantum state beside what you can get with, you know, the mathematics of Hilbert spaces? This is actually, to me, you know, a partially unanswered question, and maybe in 200 years people will think, oh, yes, of course, yes, this is trivial, but maybe they will have found ways that, at the moment, we have not yet envisioned. And this is one of the, you know, important, for the history of culture, one of the important steps that, you know, we are making at the moment. And this is one of the main reasons why I personally find this field so exciting.